Here we are for round number two. We got six pizza doughs that Nancy made for us. We're here with my good friend Matt Molina. Matt, how are you?
Fantastic.
What's up, sucker?
How are you?
I'm living the dream. What are we gonna do?
We're gonna first show you how to treat the dough that took a little bit of time to make. One thing you wanna be careful is that because it's yeasty, it's living. So it's very much like you and I. We're both
yeasty and living.
Yes, exactly. Yes. You know, mainly that we're living, and that you have to be sensitive with it, because it's during the process that, of all those times that you sat waiting 45 minutes for the dough to come up.
Sure.
It's been developing these beautiful air pockets.
So what are you doing? Throwing down a little cornmeal?
A little bit of cornmeal, just so it doesn't stick to our little pizza peel here.
I can do that.
You just want to kind of dimple it, almost like with your fingers wide open. And then stay away from the edge and concentrate on the middle.
I'm concentrating on the middle.
Okay. Now you can probably pick it up at this point.
Boom.
Yeah. And go ahead and just kind of slowly just stretch it from the middle. And you're gonna be able to create that crust.
You mean like this?
Yeah, absolutely. And the gravity itself is going to pull and give you that. Don't worry about that.
Don't worry about it.
Yeah. You're done.
You're
gonna lay it down.
Okay.
Beautiful.
And we can fix those holes?
We can fix the holes. It has some pliability to it as well. So a little bit of flour.
And now it's perfect and it's repaired.
And now it's repaired. So one of the first pizzas we fell in love with was at Pizzeria Mozza was the fennel sausage pizza. And I think it's definitely one of the most popular.
All right, so we just sprinkle on a little salt, a little olive oil around what will be the crust?
Absolutely, because we have a canvas, so we just want to season it.
What are we putting on there? What is it? Looks
a little, panna or a cream that's been whipped. But back to your oil statement or your mention is that it actually basically provides a little bit of a tan for the suntan lotion for the pizza dough. So it's going to give it a nice color sheen on when it's done. So what we're going to do next is we're going to take the fennel sausage, which we make in-house here.
Of course.
We're going to break it up. Some green onion and some red onion. We're going to do some mozzarella.
Some mozzarella. Now this oven is what?
This oven's around 520 degrees.
Right.
30, somewhere around there. And then the floor temperature, which is really important, especially for this dough, we keep around 500.
Okay.
So when the dough goes in, it has a great spring back. So it's gonna rise immediately, hopefully.
So 500 degrees, this is gonna cook how quickly?
This will cook in about eight minutes.
That's it, okay. All right, Matt, fennel sausage is cooking, so we're gonna make another pie. What are we gonna do? What are you gonna show us how to make?
We're gonna do our little ode to Naples. Now, we don't make the classic Napolitana dough, which cooks at like 800 degrees for like 30 seconds.
30 seconds, right, yeah.
So we'll never be able to achieve that here, just because our dough has so much structure and it bakes longer. So, however, we love the ingredients, so we're gonna put the staples of Naples on our pie. So what we do is, again, start off with the olive oil.
Just on the crust.
Just on the crust.
A little salt.
A little salt. A little tomato passata or tomato sauce.
Okay, great.
We do a little antipasti salad, insalata caprese, with in the pizzeria and here in Mozza to Go, and we have to have the cherry tomatoes on the vine. If they're not on the vine, then it just doesn't really pull off the effect.
They're like candy.
Yeah. So we take the ones that fall off the vines and we slowly roast them in an oven for about 250 degrees for about an hour or so, and so they come out really nice and sweet, almost like sun-dried tomatoes.
Some anchovy.
Normally we'll put some olives, but I understand that you're not a big fan of olives. So
we're not a fan of the olive.
So we're going to leave them out here.
Okay.
And we'll come back to it when you're not here.
You can come back to it when I'm not here. That's for
now,
sure.
Now, we're also going to put some fresh basil leaves on here.
Beautiful.
We're going to cook this halfway, and then we're going to add the cheese to it.
Okay, so step two of that Napolitano pizza, we're taking this out.
We're gonna take it out. We're gonna take our bufala mozzarella here, which again is the one that sits in the water for Campania.
Yes, it is the one. Yep.
And we're just gonna break it up and we're gonna put it on. Now again, if we put it on originally because our dough specifically cooks for a longer time, it would become chewy.
Right.
It'd be chewy. So we don't
want
to do
we
that.
Don't want chewy.
Oh, yeah, we don't want chewy. We want delicate. We want milky.
But this is really going back in now to just really kind of melt the cheese?
Melt the cheese, a little bit. Break it down. So right about now, we have the fennel sausage pizza ready to come out.
Right, coming out. Whoa.
Look at that.
It's beautiful.
No holes in that one. Way to go, you made it.
Yeah, that was mine, the one without the holes. Thank you.
Okay.
Gorgeous. Love it.
gorgeous, love it. So you gotta finish this thing. So the last thing that we put on is the fennel pollen.
Little fennel pollen.
Okay, which is like gold in Tuscany. Yeah, it's extremely aromatic.
Just give it a little.
Yeah, it's basically the dried flour from the...
Is that a little or is that a lot?
Keep going.
Keep going. Yeah. Right, a little extra spritz.
Done.
Done. Napolitano, cheese melted.
Ready to go.
Boom, it's coming out. Piping hot here. Boom, done, that's it.
We're gonna finish it with just a little extra virgin olive oil.
Okay.
You see the char from the basil and the tomato. You want to give it a good whack because the dough's got great structure, but we like crispy. So
are we talking about the pizza? When you're talking about giving it a good whack.
We're talking about the pizza giving it a good whack. It's been tempered a bit.
Such a beautiful looking pizza. I'm thinking that's great. I'm Billy Harris, your Hang with Harris, my good friend Matt Molino. Thanks, Matt. Come to Pizzeria Mozza in Los Angeles. And the cookbook's coming out, right? It's the Mozza cookbook, so it's the pizzeria and the osteria.
Absolutely.
Everything. Thanks for something. I'll pick that up, too, if he tries to get it.